Hey there, if you want to follow along exactly with this video, there are some exercise files that you can download. There is a link in the description, they're free to download. The other thing you might do is, this is a free video from my larger user experience design course. If you enjoy the video and like my teaching style, you might want to check out the full course. There'll be a link in the description as well. All right, on to the video. All right, a couple of things we need to discuss before we move on is some of the terminology that gets used in both this course and in the industry, just so that you know what I'm talking about when I'm going through the course. The main ones are, if you've ever seen like job applications online where they say you need to be a UX UI designer or a product designer. So we'll cover kind of what those are and what the different responsibilities are. Now, before we go on, I act as all of them. Okay, I work as a freelancer, so I take on small projects and I have to do it all. So I'll discuss what they all are individually. And basically, if you're in a small 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 man agency or design shop, you are going to be it. You're going to be the UI designer, UX designer, and the product designer. And if you're working at larger companies, larger organizations, or bigger agencies, you might be split off and be one of these things individually. So, what is it? UI designer is the person responsible for making things. Okay, so you'll be looking at kind of, say it's a website design, you'll be the looking through, you know, consistent icons you'll be building, you'll be looking at fonts and colors, kind of visual themes throughout the app or web design. So you're a UI designer, user interface, looking at the page furniture or the things that are on the page. So you can be just that, okay? A UX designer often is all of the UI stuff, plus you are looking at both the brief and the users that are going to be using it, so maybe the personas that you've built, okay, and building for that, and then testing that, okay, so working through the actual testing, and then coming back and adjusting. So UI designer often won't have that other part, okay? So yeah, that's a UX designer. You do the UI, but there's kind of some other parts around it which we'll discuss in that course. So that's the UX designer. All right, the last term we'll cover is a product designer. So what is a product designer versus a UX designer? Now, often, if I'm a product designer, what I'll be is I'll be a UX designer as well as a product designer, but I'll have more responsibility in a team. And you can't really be a product designer in a small agency or by myself like I am. You need to be in a bigger company because often the product designer has a lot of managerial roles. Okay, so you'll be in charge of not only the UI and the kind of user testing, but you'll be working with the stakeholders, the clients, and getting direction from them. You'll be working with the engineering team who's actually building this thing, and potentially the UI designers, multiple UX designers, and you'll be making sure everyone's kind of heading in the right direction, pulling in the right way. It's not the word, but you know what I mean. So a product designer has kind of a global kind of sense of the product from lots of different teams, and we'll deal with them all individually and kind of make sure everyone's going the same way. Okay, so you'll be in charge of kind of making sure budgets are hit, timelines are hit, meetings are held, you'll be doing all the meetings and the stand-ups. So product designer, I guess, yeah, is a bigger role. If you're kind of from maybe traditional design, think of it like a studio manager, okay? There's a bit more kind of organizational things involved. So to recap, product designer, okay, will look after the entire project with lots of people, make sure it's all going well and is working perfectly on budget and is working for the users and is all on the right timeline. Okay, not sure I'm waving my hands out here, but feels lofty, that role. Okay, then there's a UX designer whose sole focus is on the user. Okay, they want to make sure within the budgets that they've been given by the product designer, okay, and the timeline budgets, they want it within those boundaries. They want to make sure that the user experience is amazing. Whatever the goals are, they're getting hit, and you will test them and design and get it ready. And if you're a UI designer, often you're kind of lacking the testing phase, okay? You are looking at the more kind of traditional way of working when we're building websites, where it's just kind of like getting it up, getting it out. And the other thing to look at is that if you're at a small place or doing your own stuff like me, you are all of these. Okay, so you're just trying to make it all happen. But those are the kind of key terms you need to understand when somebody's advertising for a product designer. You know, if you're brand new, you might not be ready for that because you've never dealt with, you never run a stand up, which is kind of a meeting where everyone stands up. Quick meetings in the mornings, but you enjoy the user experience design side of it, but maybe not the product designer side. Other thing to note is that most people, the term gets used real loosely, all of them. So you'll see, students will email and say, "Is this a job that I can do?" And somebody said, "I want a graphic designer, web designer, UX designer, videographer, product designer." And they've just kind of thrown it all in there because it's either going through an HR company that's not too sure about the roles, or they're just looking for somebody who could be the best. It's a junior role and it's got product designer in there. So often you need to really clarify with whoever's got the, don't say I'm not going to do it, okay? You need to find out what the role involves, because they're just kind of, often jobs can be too vague, okay? And what they really need is somebody who's a really good print designer, but they're just thrown in other things. So really kind of find out from whoever's advertising the job what the key kind of, what the high percentage of that job work is going to be, what field, because nobody can be amazing at all of them. So check that out. Now lastly, in this course, we're looking at being a UX designer. Okay, so we're gonna look at briefs, we're gonna look at the personas, take those into account, make a beautiful product, test it, come back, make it amazing, and yeah, that's gonna be our job in this course. And we're gonna use Adobe XD to do it. All right, that's it. Let's get into the next video. We'll quickly look at our brief and the personas that we're gonna use to build our product in this course. All right, let's jump in there now. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up. It really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.